Nepi tuno fa I homalele na kuofano mo hetala mahea kane kolosi a ekueta e hautu I fa.
We are at Tokaikolo Iakalaisi Church in Mangere Bridge, and this is their facility. It's called the Api Konasareti. This church has always been considered a church that was anti-vaccination, a church that had that has some members that's been very vocal, and particularly using the scripture to dismiss and to discredit the work of the vaccination, especially around the vaccination. And that's one of the things the church leadership had wanted today to take place, is to dismiss some of that belief, because like many other churches, there are members in different churches that are vocal against vaccination, but the bulk and the large majority of this church members have already been vaccinated. But again, there's a small cohort who wasn't and wasn't going to be vaccinated. So in Auckland alone, there's about 15 different congregations under this church, and with some membership of just under 1,000 people. They're all over New Zealand and internationally also, where Tongan communities are. With the Auckland congregation, when they first floated the idea, they did conduct a survey of their 700 to 1,000 members in Auckland just to find out who has been vaccinated, who hasn't, and for those who hasn't, would they like to be vaccinated? So they were pleasantly surprised to find that there was about 200 members who have not received their first dose, and the large majority of that number wanted to have the vaccination. So today is the culmination of a lot of work from the church leadership. Still, again, working on those members that have indicated that there is no way that they would. And there has been some that are here today already who were right, dead against the vaccination, but they're here today to get their vaccination. I think first and foremost, it's the leadership who came out and made it clear the position of the church, that they do support the vaccination drive, not just here in New Zealand. There's been a struggle also back in Tonga. There are members in America and Australia who have not vaccinated. So the president himself of the church came out and said that he's been vaccinated and all members should vaccinate, because firstly, their lives without vaccination will be very restrictive. And for the church leadership and the ministers, this December they're going to be moved. The whaifikawas would be moved around or given a specific congregation to look after. There's no way that they'll be able to cross borders if they're not vaccinated. So that's one of the main reasons. Then there's their own employers who have demanded vaccination. So there's a lot of factors. So when the church leadership decided on the name for the program, they came up with the word talangofua, which literally means obedience. And the verse that goes with it is Isaiah chapter 1 verses 19 and 20. And that talks about being obedient to your leadership. And that's what they've been in the prayer this morning, that they emphasize that again, that we're here in New Zealand in this society, and this society needs us all to be vaccinated, and we should be obedient as members of this society. I'm very humbling. I'm not just a member of the church. My father was the founder of this church 40 years ago. And in the work that we do at the whānau in vaccinating everybody else in every other church, I've always had it in my heart that I hope one day we'll be here. And I think that's another reason for the church standing up and being very vocal about their true position with the vaccination, is that because of me, because they trust me, and because then they know that I will not advocate for something like this if it's not safe for our members. So I think that is another big part of their agreeing to do this and being standing up. And all of our church ministers are out on the road. They made it clear that those that they'll be waving the flags out on the front will be church ministers, to make it clear to everybody that we are obedient to the law. But first and foremost, that's still within our belief and our values and the scripture that we follow.
Manuel.